Jordan, what exactly have we found out?
Hi. Yeah, the basic gist of this story is that in 2014 and 2015, according to our reporting, a unit of China's People's Liberation Army implanted malicious microchips on computer servers bound for U.S. companies. Now, those computer servers wound up in very targeted, very large companies, including Apple and Amazon. And what these malicious chips did was compromise the software on these hardware devices at the kind of level that you can't detect. It's in many ways the ultimate silent attack. And this was a very major discovery for these companies and for U.S. intelligence services.
Yeah, and Jordan, well done, of course, for uncovering it and writing the story for Bloomberg Businessweek. But where you've kind of grown accustomed to some of the software-based incidents, is a hardware incident more serious than a software hacking?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, this story has taken, you know, well over a year for us to report and write. And, you know, a lot of that is learning what is a hardware attack. Like, it's such science fiction in many ways to us as reporters and to the public at large. A hardware attack is simply the most effective type of computer hacking that any organization can engineer. And the reason is hardware controls. If the hardware of a computer system is compromised, it will irrevocably compromise the software that sits on top of it. So there's no commercial security system that could detect that kind of manipulation. It's a super, super serious attack that just is almost impossible to detect without physical examination of the hardware, which almost no one does.
Jordan, I want to go to some of the emotion within the story with you and Mike O'Reilly, but first I want to provide a key distinction with the story, and only you can answer it. We're making allegations in Bloomberg Businessweek that the server motherboards of Apple and Amazon were compromised by these microchips the size of a grain of rice. Are we saying that the motherboards on servers of the CIA and Pentagon were compromised as well or not? Which is it?
Well, here's an interesting question. You know, one of the contractors in this story, so a subsidiary of Amazon, is a company called Elemental Technologies. Now, Elemental Technologies, appears to have been targeted because while they provide video processing technology to large like large cable companies, they also provide provided computer hardware to sensitive national security missions throughout the U.S. government.
So, do you know? I want to be clear within your reporting. In the follow-on reporting, can you suggest that these microchips placed by an operative force of the People's Liberation Army, are those microchips on U.S. Navy warships?
Oh, we don't know that for a fact.
We don't
report that, but we do know that those entities were certainly a target and a reason why that division was targeted.
If you're just joining us worldwide and moving the stocks of Apple and Amazon, Jordan Robertson and Mike O'Reilly in Bloomberg Businessweek this morning report on a hack, a cyber attack by elements of the People's Liberation Army against American corporations. Some 30 corporations are listed, including Apple, including Amazon. Jordan, I want to go to some of the emotion right now within your Bloomberg Businessweek article. Bring this up, Riley, if you could. These are just elements out of a lengthy article. As well. No, that's not what I want. I want the a chart from Matthew Riley, please, if I get it. Do we have those or not? Okay, let us continue right now, Riley. Let us continue right now, Jordan, with the idea of the technology involved. These are microchips that are placed by super micro servers. Where were they placed? In China, in Taiwan, or were they indeed even placed in California?
So according to sources for the story, these chips were implanted in these Supermicro motherboards. Supermicro is the company that makes these servers and makes these motherboards by manufacturing subcontractors in China, where the motherboards are actually made.
Well, okay, they're made in China as well. This is very strong language, Jordan, to say elements of the People's Liberation Army are involved in the cyber attack on American corporations. How have the Chinese responded?
The Chinese have not, you know, the Chinese government has not directly addressed our questions that we've submitted to them over the course of many months. Instead, the Chinese government insists that it, too, is the victim of supply chain attacks. We know from Edward Snowden's leaked documents about the NSA that indeed is the case. The U.S. government does supply chain attacks as well. However, in a very different way, this is a manufacturing hardware attack. And we have not seen an example publicly of that today.
Yeah.
Okay, Anthony, Jordan, I want, Francine, I want to show this. It's too important. Anthony, get up that white screen right now. Okay, this is the one we just had up. This is on the Yangtze River. Francine, this is some of the language within this reporting. The idea from China, let's bring it up, please. It involved China use a tiny chip. It involved seeding changes from the very beginning. Francine, a feat akin to throwing a stick in the Yangtze River upstream from Shanghai and ensuring that it washes ashore in Seattle. Its super micro China spies appear to have found a perfect conduit. Francine?
Jordan, the companies have denied this. How can we be so certain that this happened? And tell us more about the ongoing investigation. There's still a probe.
Sure. Yeah. You know, one of the things that we as journalists, of course, take very seriously is company comments. And, you know, in this story, Amazon, Apple and Supermicro, the supplier of this computer hardware, have all denied that any of these events occurred. So, of course, we take that very seriously. However, we have voluminous reporting on the other side from 17 total sources, including inside those companies, Apple, Amazon and others, and extensively within the U.S. government, that this attack did indeed occur. And as you correctly point out, this is an ongoing, highly classified, top secret U.S. government investigation. That's one reason that we believe the companies would deny this reporting. And in addition, there was no consumer data that's alleged to have been stolen. This attack was about long-term access to sensitive networks. So by that logic, companies are not required to disclose this information. So there's no advantage for these companies in confirming this reporting.
So, Jordan, in your reporting with Michael Riley that took more than 12 months, who actually detected this suspicious chip, which, again, is the size of a grain of rice first?
Yeah, this is an amazing story because, you know, these attacks happen probably more often than we're aware of. But companies simply don't look at their hardware to see if these malicious types of microchips are there. The way these were discovered was the companies, in Amazon's case, it was acquiring a company called Elemental Technologies. And as part of a pre-acquisition security audit, our reporting shows, they subjected the hardware to testing. They found some indicators of malicious behavior on those servers. And then they dug deeper and they found these microchips. In Apple's case, our understanding is it was a random spot check of some problematic servers that led to this detection. Most companies do not have the resources of an Amazon or an Apple to go looking for these hardware manipulations. So in many ways, Amazon and Apple could be kind of a model for how you do this work if you have those resources.
And what was the intent, Jordan? Was it to spy? Is it intellectual property? Was it to gain access to information? Is it, you know, hacking for something else?
Yeah, when we first started learning about this information, our assumption, which I assume many members of the public's assumption would be as well, was this must have been about stealing consumer data. You break into the Siri network at Apple to steal Siri consumer data. That's not the case at all. All of the evidence that we've been able to acquire and the source interviews we've been able to conduct, you know, indicates this attack, this kind of hardware attack, is all about access. It's all about opening a secret backdoor into sensitive networks for long-term access. It's not about consumer data at all. And some of our sources tell us that the goal of the attack, right, according to intercepted communications, was theft of intellectual property from these corporations.
Jordan, to give the president great credit, he and the Secretary of Commerce and others have been way out front on this. I would suggest Washington is modestly distracted this morning with other matters. Let's take a guy like Senator Mark Warner, who's been a technologist for his whole life, a senator from Virginia, is very astute on this. We have Senator Rounds coming up at some point, again, very astute on this as well. How would these senior government officials respond to the idea that the People's Liberation Army has microchips on servers of 30 U.S. companies?
You know, one of the things that we wanted to make really clear in the story was that, you know, obviously the Trump administration is very hard on China in many ways. And so was the Obama administration, at least privately. I mean, these discussions began with us,
right,
you know, under Obama. And I would suspect, you know, that folks that have been read into these classified briefings have been aware of this for some time, but it's never been made public
okay.
before. So I expect that they would react pretty strongly.
But within this and within the denials and the well-laid-out denials within your story, can the people watching worldwide know that Amazon's cloud system does not have these microchips on their server motherboards?
Well, that's a hard question for me to answer.
You don't know the answer to that. Okay.
We don't know. It's one of the questions that these companies will be, I think, forced to answer is what are their policies and procedures to make sure that nothing like this happens again or that nothing like this is currently ongoing. It's a very hard problem. It's a very, very hard problem because you think about a company like Amazon, which has hundreds of thousands of servers around the world. They can't physically check every single one of them for hardware modification. So they have to come up with other ways. And it's a very, very imperfect system.
Jordan, how common is this? Do other countries do it? Does the U.S. do it?
Well, so according to Edward Snowden's leaked documents about the NSA, the U.S. absolutely does it. The U.S. spends billions of dollars trying to figure out ways to hack into other countries. The difference is the U.S. used to be a manufacturing base. We no longer are for computer hardware. So what the U.S. government has to do is intercept shipments of pre-assembled computers and hack into them that way. The advantage China has, and the folks that we've talked to for this story, the advantage China has is China owns manufacturing and a final assembly for many of these computer components and computer systems. So if China wants to hack into systems at the manufacturing level, China has an advantage that no other country has.
Jordan, I know in your wider reporting, will this have an impact actually on Asian chip makers overall? Do you think that this could blow up in a concern about safety of, you know, making some of the components not in the U.S.?
You know, I think it could. I mean, you know, there's this idea of, you know, obviously the Trump administration is very strong on we should bring manufacturing back to the U.S. for certain sensitive components. And there may be some logic to that. And I think that, but I think the bigger picture is companies and organizations have to look at their hardware. They have to do security audits of their hardware. And right now, that's just really not being done because it upends the business model. You know, a lot of Silicon Valley's business model is based on this idea of inexpensive computer hardware outsourced to China and other places in Asia. When you start adding layers of security onto the computer hardware, it gets more expensive. So it has not been part of the business model for many companies, including suppliers, to your point, to look for these kinds of things. So I would expect that companies would try to differentiate themselves by saying, hey, we do extensive hardware security analysis to supply that level of comfort to consumers.
All right, Jordan, thank you so much. Of course, our Bloomberg technology reporter, Jordan Robertson, who's done a lot of the reporting and, of course, was one of the lead writers on this amazing Bloomberg Business Week story.